Hi, and welcome to Painting the Shed. Thanks for joining me on this episode. This is quite a nice little story, actually. This is quite a nice little video. I get commissions quite a lot on emails, and I had this email a while ago, quite a long time ago actually now, from a woman called Jackie saying, could you do a painting for me and my husband's wedding anniversary? I've done a painting for them previously, and she said, you know, I just want you to sort of pray and paint whatever you feel is right for us. And she gave me an idea of the lighthouse and things, and she gave me quite a bit of info. And I thought, okay, well, when is it? She said early December. So I thought, well, I've got loads of time, you know, I'll do an idea. And this is the first painting that I did up here, using the lighthouse idea. Towards, like, I think it was November sort of time, I got another email from a guy, and I recognized the surname, and then I recognized the date of the anniversary, and I'm thinking, this is her husband, so I'm doing a secret painting for him, and now he's asking me to do a surprise painting for her. So I had a bit of a dilemma, like what to do with, you know, so I thought, the answer would be is to paint them both a picture, send it to two different addresses. So he gave me a different address to send the painting to, and they would give it to each other on the anniversary. And I asked them to film it, so they did actually film the whole unwrapping and unveiling. But another thing I did was that instead of just doing two separate paintings, I actually did one that would fit together. So I redid the lighthouse one, and then I made another painting of what he wanted, some locations and stuff that he'd give me an idea of, and I'd made it into one big painting. So this is, it was really fun. Anyway, this is me painting the picture. So I started by screwing together the two canvases so that I can make one painting on these two canvases here. So I start off with a black sort of pastel pencil, and I sketch out the idea, you know, roughly. I had to make the composition work for both the canvases separately, but also the whole painting as a whole, which was quite a challenge really, because you know, each section had to work on its own in case they didn't want to display the paintings together at all. I started off here with titanium white, lemon yellow, burnt sienna, and this is Prussian blue. And I used quite a lot of paint thinners on this, you know, like white spirit or turpentine or whatever. I used quite a lot of it at the beginning here just to kind of get this sort of sunset-y kind of feel to it. I think here I sort of added some, like I mixed the lemon yellow and the blue together at the bottom there to get sort of the watery colour down the bottom there, which you get in Cornwall sometimes, or down in the south you get sort of quite nice coloured water. And here I'm starting to add the crimson in between the yellow areas and the blue areas just to stop that going too green. I wanted it a little bit green, but I just wanted to get rid of a lot of the green up in the sky there. And I'm using big round bristle brush here to sort of soften it all and take a lot of the paint back off. I sort of put some on and take it all off. And then here I'm putting the darker areas back in again. This is crimson and Prussian blue. And is it Prussian or Prussian? I never know how to say that, I always forget. And obviously this is the Harry's Rocks or whatever in the south of England. I had quite several photographs on me that I used for this painting. I wanted it to be sort of correct in some ways, but I also wanted it to have a bit of an atmosphere to it. So I sort of, artistic license really, sort of changed some of it a little bit. This is just, that's burnt umber that I put on there for the darker areas of the rock. So I sort of went back and forward with this titanium white and the burnt umber to get the highlights. And you can see all that running down there on the canvas. That's where I just used paint thinners and just ran it down the canvas, and that kind of gives you that reflection. I really like that. That was a fan brush that I used on the water there, which is quite a flat brush, and that gives you nice sort of horizontal strokes to get the water reflections. There's my lighthouse and the people. The people were done with the blue and the little bit of crimson, and here I'm using the fan brush again for the grass, which is sort of burnt sienna, burnt umber, yellow ochre. Just kind of used an old brush for that to give it, you know, give it a nice grassy sort of pattern to it. And a bit of shadow there on the people. That's pretty much it. And as you can see, each painting hopefully works as an individual painting, but together it shows the whole bay and the people standing on the top there. Yeah, that's it. Well, that's the painting done, and now we're going to watch a bit of footage of them unwrapping the paintings that they filmed for me.
Well, we've been asked to video opening the presents, both of us.
Both of us have been asked.
You can go first.
What?
Can I open first?
You open first.
Okay. It is slightly suspicious we've both been asked.
And it's been wrapped the same way.
And it's the same shape and size.
And it's got the same... There's a pair of scissors just down the side.
Same.
Wow.
Old Harry's Rock, isn't it?
That is Old Harry's Rock. That is amazing. Happy 20th wedding anniversary.
Oh.
Can you take a picture? Yeah.
One of our favourite places.
Glad I had such an original idea.
That's so funny. I just can't believe we've both done the same thing.
Chances of that. Wow, lighthouse. That is amazing. The camera is. Look at that. See. So. Oh, look at that. These are amazing. So you've gone for the lighthouse and I've gone for Old Harry's Rocks, which needs a lighthouse.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you all so much.
Thank you, Oliver.
Thank you. You are so
amazing.
Gifted.
Can't believe. We've just twigged. Oliver, it's one painting. That is genius.
Oh my goodness.
We hadn't realised.
That's why you said to keep the camera rolling.
Oh, wow. Because we opened them in a different order, I hadn't twigged until we put them like that. That is so cool. Ah, oh, wow. So the two paintings are one as well. Happy anniversary.
I'm so pleased that that painting turned out well, and what an exciting commission that was to do two paintings for the same couple. It was a real honour to be asked, and so if you want to commission a painting, please send me an email, either through my website oliverpengelly.co.uk or through my Facebook page Oliver Pengelly, or even my Etsy store. I think you can communicate through there, or Instagram, or Twitter, and I'm on all of it. Or here on YouTube, you can contact me here as well. But if you want to visit my Etsy store, I have some calendars left, and I've only had a few left, so if you really want a calendar, make sure you order it. If there are any left in January, I might do a January sale on them, looking at how many's left, I'm not sure. So please, you know, so here's a link to the calendar. Please buy a calendar if you want one. There are desk calendars and gift cards and things like that on my Etsy store. So please check out the store. I don't know where I'll put the link, but order your stuff there. Well, I might not be able to do a video now until after Christmas, so Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Thank you for watching and subscribing if you have done to this YouTube channel. Anyway, thank you for watching. Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.